parents don't care my girlfriend died. My 15 meters girlfriend, 15F, unexpectedly died last week. I was with her for over a year. She was my first kiss and I loved her a lot. My parents don't seem to care. They say it's time to get over it and stop crying. They say it was a dumb, meaningless relationship at my age and that we would have broken up anyway. They say I didn't really love her because I'm only 15. They won't get me therapy or support me. How can I feel better about GF dying? How can I get parents to support me? Are they right about it being meaningless? Is there maybe a school counselor you can talk to? I'm so sorry. Op, I'm so sorry for your loss. Please reach out to your school for help. Dealing with the death of someone you know is very difficult. Even if it is a classmate or friend, it is still traumatic. And this was someone you were close to. That makes it more difficult. Did you go to the same school? Is the school offering counseling? Are they organizing a memorial? Dealing with the death of someone you know is very difficult. Even if it is a classmate or friend, it is still traumatic. Honestly, this is true. Even classmates passing is awful. I had a classmate that committed suicide in 10th grade. I didn't even know them, but it was bad. Had to go to a counseling thing simply because I suffered from the same feelings they had before passing and everything. It's not easy to deal with the death of just anyone. Op, that was your GF. Regardless of your age, it doesn't matter, cause she meant something to you. I'm 19. I'm very immature. But if my main partner died, I'd be devastated. It wouldn't take a week to just get over it, and your parents need to understand that. Some people take years to move past the death of loved ones, while others take days. They are being ridiculous and rude by being like this. They need help or something. And I know that's wrong to say. But seriously. No one in the right mindset would say that to someone grieving. And I agree with everyone else. Op, you should talk to your school counselor about how you feel and such too. It's not good to suppress your feelings for something this big either. And I'd just like to say, I'm so deeply sorry for your lose, Op. I know it hurts. But hopefully with time it will get better. Just don't let this stop you from loving again. She wouldn't want that from you, okay? She'd like you to be happy, and she'll be there to help and support you, even if you can't see her. I wish the best for you, okay? Edit 1. Thank you, lovely stranger or strangers, for the awards. They're the first ones I've ever received here and it truly means so much to me. Don't worry, I'll make you guys proud. Edit 2. 253 likes. OMG, thank you all so much. This is so wonderful. I've never received this many likes before. And to everyone who's experienced the passing, if someone close to them, I'm so sorry for your losses. I wish the best for all of you also who's also dealing with the passing of friends currently. You're not alone, and we are here for you. Friendships and loves in childhood are not meaningless. I lost one of my childhood friends when I was about 10 or 11. The bullies at school made fun of his death. I'm in my 30s, and I still miss him. And I hate that assholes made fun of him. I miss all the people I have lost, and even years later I get hit by the occasional wave of sadness and heartache. That sorrow has become a comfort, like a familiar friend that visits me and brings along the memories of those people. They are never completely gone. I hope that when the initial pain and shock wears off, that you can hold the good you had together close to your heart. As for your family, what they have said is appalling. You might be stuck with them now. But try to surround yourself with people who love and support you and who have compassion and empathy. People who raise you up instead of trying to drag you down to their level. If you can find a counselor to speak to, grief can easily turn to self-destruction and you are at a vulnerable age. Edit. Thanks for the rewards. I second this. I'm so sorry, Op. We are with you, and we know how it feels. Don't give up, and let the memory of her make you feel loved and special. If you ever need to talk, my DMs are open. 15 is an absolutely tragic age. To die and her being your girlfriend is a very important connection. You are allowed to be absolutely devastated and even traumatized. Your parents are really wrong here. They can say whatever they want. But you need to mourn her at your own pace. I would suggest finding another adult, like a counselor to reach out to. I would suggest finding another adult. I completely agree. And I think there may be two adults who know exactly how he feels, his girlfriend's parents, if he was on good terms with them at all. It may be a light slash minor outlet for opus. I say minor, as in not primary or not a lot, because you don't want to wear out your welcome. Op, if you are a good person, in their opinion, you may be able to talk with those parents a little bit. Maybe even confess that your own parents are not sympathetic, and ask if they would be okay to talk about their daughter once in a while, or to let him come by and chat once in a while. Maybe they might share with him a story about when she was younger, maybe share some photos, but go at a slow pace. Don't overwhelm the parents. Don't try to make them into your new parents. They are just sympathetic people who shared a loss, and they might be good enough or kind enough to treat Op with some love and understanding. If Op is lucky, this also assumes that he was on their good side prior to the girlfriend dying. If he was considered a punk or a jerk or a problem, then now is probably not the time to visit them. They shouldn't care that it was a meaningless relationship. Someone close to you just died. They need to realize that you're going to grieve for that loss. I'm sorry you're going through this, Op. Wow, your parents seem to be assholes. It's a dead person, not just a breakup. I don't know how to get over it, but I guess it wasn't meaningless. You are allowed to feel whatever you feel about this. It is not meaningless. I'm so sorry your parents are being so dismissive of your feelings. That definitely isn't right. It doesn't matter if maybe you were broken up. This is a human being that unfortunately passed. I hope you can find better support for this. I'm sorry for your loss. I don't understand your parents. Even if it was the death of a random classmate and not of a girlfriend, the death of a 15 years old girl would still be very tragic and super sad. Even without knowing the girl, just knowing someone of your town died that young is awful, and one would feel sad for her family. But she was your girlfriend, which obviously touches you way way more, as you are part of people who knew her and cherished her. How can they not understand how hurt you are? ? Do you have contact with the girl's parents? Perhaps being in contact with them would be better than grieving alone. Grieving with others who feel the same sorrow could help. It could also help them. Hearing someone deeply cared about their daughter, I would advise you to contact her best friends and surround yourself with people who understand the pain just as much as you do, because it's not the case with your parents. That's what I was thinking. Either the parents are psychopaths or they just don't have the ability to help. All they can think of is to say, don't be sad, you'll get over this, you're young. But 1. Telling someone in mourning not to be sad is cruel and naive. 2. This is a tragedy most adults don't have to deal with until they are older. 3. Parents have perspective, but that sometimes makes them out of touch. Even if this was just a puppy love breakup, that could possibly be the worst thing to ever happen to a child. It is a very large tragedy for them. Don't miss out on major parenting moments because you personally don't feel something is a big deal. That's called empathy. And like I said, this is a tragedy on any scale. This remembers me something. If it was a puppy love breakup, Op still had the total right to be sad and depressed. When I had my first breakup, I thought it was my fault. Like, I'm not perfect enough and I need to get more pretty. This turned into a terrible habit of locking up in my room and crying and being angry at myself for being a loser. I actually got depression from a breakup. And you know what my parents did? They loved and supported me because they knew I was depressed and sad. But a ducking death. Death is way worse than just a breakup. And the parents are saying that it doesn't matter? ! Ducking, tell that to her parents, to her friends, and see if that doesn't matter. Opus. Please. Try and get in contact with a responsible adult and surround yourself with support. Oh honey. How horrible. My condolences. My mom used to trivialize major things and even just change the subject when I was feeling bad and needed to talk. We discussed it later in life, and she told me that she worried I would focus too much on bad stuff and she did not want to encourage me to wallow in misery. Her heart was in the right place. But I do wish she would have been more sensitive to my feelings. I'm glad that I spoke to her about it, because it was a sad and sore spot for me surrounding my relationship with her. Maybe your parents are doing the same sort of thing. I hope that there are other people you have in your life who are supportive. It really does take a village. Love to you. This. If I was him, I would actually talk to my parents about why they are acting like that, and if that may be the reason. Think about it, this is not a character thing, because both of them acting like that means they probably talked about it and about how they should treat him. Maybe, just maybe, they got the wrong way to solve this problem. They should realize that it isn't an actual problem, but more an emotional state of devastation of their son, and that, if they actually do love him, they should be there for him. No matter what emotional pain he goes through in life. I'm truly sorry for your loss. You really need to cry and feel your feelings. A year isn't a lot to people, but it wasn't their relationship. They don't know how close you guys were, or how strong you bonded over the course of it. I personally know it feels. And our experiences are similar, but not the same. The best advice I can give you is find someone who will lend you a shoulder to lean on when you need it. Grieving is a long process at times. You'll have good days and bad. It may feel like you're alone, but you're not. You can try finding places online where you can let stuff out, such as here. You might have insurance, if they have it, but try looking at the legal advice sub to see if you might be able to seek therapy for yourself. Sometimes they even pay for the ride to and from. Your parents are so in the wrong and just think it was puppy love. That doesn't mean it still doesn't hurt to lose the person you loved. I really hope you are able to get help. Again, I'm sorry for your loss. If you ever need to talk, I'm here. That's awful. And no, they're not right about it being meaningless. Death at any age is not meaningless. And anyone who says otherwise just has a cold heart. Are your parents usually like that, or is this out of the blue for them? Please reach out to your friends in this time if you can. Or maybe siblings / extended family / teachers. Remember, you don't get to choose your family, but you can choose to surround yourself with people who give you the love, respect and comfort you deserve. I'm so sorry for your loss. I can't imagine how you must feel. Sending all the love your way, friend. I'm so sorry for your loss. Your parents talk bullshit. I found my husband when I was 15. And now we are 13. 5Y happy and 1.5Y married. So love in this age is more than just an illusion. They told me same when I was your age. Your love was true, and it will take a long time to heal. Feel yourself hugged. Fuck. Your parents are cold. Handling death at 15 years old, and she was your GF. What's wrong with parents these days? I'm so sorry this happened, and that your family is not being supportive. It is absolutely not meaningless. You need time and support to feel the feelings you have, and just grieve for a while. Try finding friends who are willing to support you, or a school counselor, or even just finding resources by Death Doulas online. No one can dictate what grief should feel like. And your parents are being very inconsiderate. If you have the energy to, I would try directly telling your parents that you are feeling sad, and even if they don't understand your feeling, they need to respect it. Them not doing so is making you feel even more horrible, and is making you feel like they're not on your side. My auntie and uncle were together from 14 years old, married, have now grown up children. So I do not think it was a meaningless relationship. I'm so sorry you're dealing with this without the support you need. Is there not someone at school you could speak to that could get you some help and support, sweetheart? Whether you would have stayed together forever or not, having someone that close to you die at your age is highly traumatic, and you definitely need therapy. Maybe talk to your school and see if they can get you any help. I'm so sorry for your loss, and don't listen to your parents. Your feelings are completely valid. This is so heartbreaking. So very sorry for your loss, and yes, you can 100% experience true love at your age. Definitely try a school counselor, otherwise there may be a hotline you can call. Here in Aus we have Kids Helpline. There will be help available to you. Otherwise, work as hard as you can at school to get a full scholarship to a uni on the other side of the country. Move out and give your parents the middle finger and a nice big fuck off out the door. They are seriously trash. My husband is 76. He was dating a girl at 17 who was suddenly killed in a car accident. To this day, if the subject randomly comes up, he speaks quietly and thoughtfully about the young lady. I believe that he considers her the love of his life. I'm his fourth wife. Almost 30 years. I'm so very sorry for your loss. I truly hope you are able to get some counseling through your school. Please reach out to them, or to a trusted adult, if your parents are refusing to help you. I will say a prayer for you and your girl. Good luck. Op put minimal details in this story, and got hundreds of sympathy messages back. Only responded to the people calling this fake. Wow. This is horrible. This person clearly meant something to you. Obviously. Whether the relationship was meaningful in their eyes. If someone who means something to you dies, it is only natural that you mourn them. It doesn't matter whether it was your GF or friend, family member, pet or whatever. The more they meant to you, the harder it is on you. You should mourn them as long as you need to. Take your time. Mourning is so important, and they should let you take your time. You have every right to. You are human. It's really insensitive from them. Imo. Please don't let them take mourning from you. For the sake of your emotional and mental well-being, or you will need a therapist. Also, I think she deserves to be mourned by you for as long as you need to. HM. Tell them to back off and respect your feelings. Honestly, that's quite toxic. Edit. Also, sorry for your loss. What? Even if it was a friend, your parents shouldn't be so callous. She was just a young girl and it's tragic. Go find another adult you trust or can trust and ask them for help. My crush died when we were 16. Still think of her 20 years later. Sorry dude, must be super difficult, especially without support. I'm sorry for your loss and can't even imagine what you must be feeling. I'm not sure that therapy is the answer to everything, but you will have to process this, and with time it will get better, but incrementally. I don't understand your parents on this, and it could be their misguided way of trying to help by downplaying it, but they are wrong. Your parents are 100% wrong. I would check with the school you go to in order to see if there is a counselor you can speak with. Frankly, this is mostly beyond Reddit's abilities. Try to see if your school has a counselor, or try some of the crisis helplines. Failing that, try out BetterHelp. Sorry for your loss. Is this real? I find it hard to believe someone's parents would be this cold. Op's profile is gone. He probably deleted it and is seeing none of this. So sorry about your loss, mate. But let me make it clear. Just because you two are only 15, that doesn't mean your love are childish and temporary. I've attended numerous weddings where the bride and groom were actually beginner's teen lovers. Yes, I knew that sometimes parental advice are much better than a random guy speech. But they are still humans. They have their limits. They actually love you and want you to stop crying over the past and look up for the future. Unfortunately for you, they can't express it correctly, and it ended up irritating you even more. You're free to express your concern with us. Don't let anyone judge you for expressing your grief. You have right to do so, and it's totally normal. It just took some time. Your parents are assholes. This is despicable. Your feelings are more than valid, and caring parents should be the first to help you process them. Please find a therapist or other outlet for help, because they are almost certainly doing other psychological damage that you don't even realize yet. Throw away for no reason. Parents are inexplicably cruel. Asking if they're right when they obviously aren't. All of your comments are responding to people calling you out. Try harder at it. It's so frustrating that so many adults don't remember how genuine emotions are when you're young. Sure, they've experienced more and have been able to gain perspective. But you don't have that. And dismissing your trauma because they think they know better is heartless and ignorant. Not to mention, losing a loved one at any age is tragic. If your best friend died, would they say the same thing? If one of them died, would they say the same thing? Maybe. But I would hope not. The idea that young love is somehow lesser than adult love is silly and insensitive. Your feelings are valid. Mourn the loss of your girlfriend. And reach out to people who will support you and mourn with you. I agree with those saying to pursue therapy. Grief counselors are trained in guiding people through the loss of loved ones and can do wonders. I call BS. Why would you need a throwaway for this? Question mark? If it is actually true, then I'm incredibly sorry for your loss, and I hope you get the help and support circle around you that you need. I choose to believe that this isn't real purely based on the fact that it seems like that ITA straight up just too horrible for me to want it to be real. Please click subscribe if you enjoyed this video.